Hi everybody, and thanks for stopping by. I wanted to do a quick video on something that I struggled with when I got my first digital wireless thermometer, and that was how to program the thing. The first ones were not easy, and they're getting easier and easier. The one that I have, the one that I recently purchased, was the ThermoPro TP-08, and I want to take a couple minutes to show you how to program that to give you an idea. So this is the ThermoPro TP-08. They have other models. I think there's a TP-20. I'm sure there's ones in between, up, down, below, better, worse. This one is very good. I think I paid just under $50 for it, maybe between $45 and $49, and really simple to program. So let me show you. So this is the unit, very compact, not a lot of buttons, has 7 buttons, and very simple. First of all, you have your turn on button. And then you have your sync button if it doesn't automatically sync with the sending unit. My sending unit right now is out by my smoker, just sitting there. I don't have anything cooking. So we're seeing a food temperature of 109 because the probe is just lying in the sun, and a pit temperature of 121 because the pit's a little hotter because it's an enclosed steel structure. Normally it will sync within about 20 to 30 seconds on its own, sometimes quicker. If not, you just need to use the sync button, pressing that, and that helps it along. Okay, so we have our readouts. As I said, here's your food readout. Temperature just went up out in the sun to 111. It's not 111 degrees outside, but that probe gets hot. It absorbs the sunlight. And 121 pit temperature. Let's say I want to set an alarm for my internal food temperature. I press this, and that's what it's set at right now. Mine is set at 120. But let's say I want to cook a tri-tip to medium, not to sort of a medium rare. I'm going to actually raise that. So what I need to do first is press this button once, the food clear button, and then press it again and hold it down until it starts flashing. And I'm going to raise that. And you got to do it within a few seconds, otherwise it just goes back down and sets. Oh, I went too far. I got to bring it back down to 130. Use that down arrow button. Mode light sets the temperature. Now that temperature is locked in. So that's my food temperature. Now on your pit temperature, or as listed here, barbecue temperature, you can set two numbers. You can set a high and you can set a low. This is barbecue high, this is barbecue low. Let's set the barbecue high in the same way we did the food, by first pressing it once and then holding it down. It's flashing. 260 is too low for me. I want to raise that to 275. So I'm going to go up to 275. And I'm going to confirm it with the mode light. So my upper pit temp is now set at 275. If it exceeds that, the alarm will go off if you've set the alarm to actually go off and be audible. So now let's set a low temp or minimum temp, which will tell us if our pit is dropping below a certain temperature. This is really helpful in long cooks where you're going to have to add wood over time. So let's see what we're set at. 220, that's a little too low for me. So I'm going to hold this down again till it flashes, and I'm going to raise that to 230. And I'm going to confirm it with mode light. So now we have three different temperatures set on here. We have our food temp, that's our target temp. We have our barbecue high temp, and we have our barbecue low temp. Now, let's say you don't want the alarm to go off. You just want that visible sort of thing where that number will come up. This button right here turns the alarm on and off. Also changes Fahrenheit and Celsius. So let's press that once. The alarm symbols both went off. I don't know if you can see that. Let's press it again. The alarm symbols both went on. This one, you can't turn these off individually so that one will alarm and the other won't, but I don't really see a need for that. I want to know if my pit temp is too low, too high, and if my food is reaching its internal temp that I've set for it. And again, if you want to change Fahrenheit to Celsius, there you go. Okay, you want to go back to Fahrenheit? Hold it down. There we go, we're back to Fahrenheit. Want to set the alarm back on? Press it once. So we're back into Fahrenheit with our alarm on. We have our food temp, we have our high pit temp, and our low pit temp. And that's all there is to it. I hope that was helpful for you. I know that when I first started out, I didn't watch enough videos on how to do these things and how to program things. And I had wished that there were some just quick, simple videos and show me how to do those steps. So I wanted to try and do this one for anyone out there who might have struggled like I did. And every time you get a new one, sometimes the procedures are different, so you kind of got to go through them and teach yourself again until they're second nature. So thank you all for watching. Hope you have a great day, and I'll see you again soon.